Actually, she's from India. She's from Indore, Madhya Pradesh, I think. She's doing her master's in from the Medill University. Medill is one of the topmost universities in the world in Chicago. You know, she was, as a part of her project, you know, she was making Paulo Coelho's profile. You know, there is a project in some pages, you know, maybe some 10, 15, 25 pages. There is her first year project. While she was going through the net and all that, she found my name. You know, there is one small village fellow which Paulo Coelho has, you know, made a fast Facebook posting and Twitter posting and all those things. And somehow, from the Twitter, for that purpose only, she opened an account in Twitter because she doesn't know how to get me in that. She just sent a tweet saying that, sir, I'm a student, I'm doing this. I want your help, I'm making a profile. How can I contact you? I replied her back, you know, much easier. You know, you follow me and I follow you. And we can send a DM. You know, there is a direct message feature in Twitter, which all my followers need not read. It goes to the person only, Nikita. She followed me, I followed her back. And I sent a message saying that, you know, you send me a question so that I can reply. She said that, no, I want to talk to you. Is it possible? I'll take a few minutes of yours. I said, anytime you can call. And I just shared my mobile. And the next, she made a DM again in the next morning. She asked me whether I can call you now. I said, yes. I was in my association office there. She called me. And the questions, you know, very interesting questions. Like, you know, my experience with Paulo Coelho. You know, what is your experience? You know, how did you find him? I said, my experience is limited to only two Twitters or one Facebook this, or a couple of mails, you know. She said that even that is a one mail and one Twitter, he replied you and, you know, he interacted with you. It is a big thing, sir. You know, that is Paulo Coelho. I said, like that, I have about three mails, you know, exchange and a couple of this thing. And not only that, in his Twitter account, he carried my picture. You know, the programs my for months. And then she wants to know that, you know, why I have translated that book, why I have chosen that book, Alchemist. She read that book, and you know, there are a lot of things are happening. For the last 7 years, the Alchemist is in the bestseller list now. There is a 7 years, 6 months and few days now. Every week he's updating it. It is in the bestsellers now. He said that, what made you do this? Then I told that, you know, what is my passion, or, you know, my favorite pastime is talking to the children of the village schools. You know, the underprivileged children, we call them. They may be the coolie labor children or the government school, medium school children, you know, where they don't have a privilege or an opportunity to read this kind of a book. And I thought I have to give them the dreams. So actually, this is the common platform what myself and Paulo Coelho are sharing. You know, he has a foundation called Paulo Coelho Foundation. I have a foundation called Salma Bawa Foundation. You know, he said that he cannot change the world, so he adopted a street. I said that I cannot even adopt a street, so I have adopted a child. Maybe after this child, another child. You know, it might go on. This is how we started that. And he totally waived off his royalty and all that. He said that even though he had no rights of that book, he has already sold it to his publishers. He said that in such cases, I wouldn't have asked anybody's permission. You can go ahead. Not only that, he put it in his Twitter. I told her this, you know, he put it in Twitter and in his Facebook also, that, you know, the gentleman is doing this in Karnataka. If anybody wants to do, they can approach me and all that, but they should go reach to the people. So this is how it happened. You know, I thought that even he put a small mail to my colleague, one Mr. Paulo's, you know, to you. I just referred that the mail also. But still, I was reluctant to take that offer. You know, I don't know how his publisher will behave. The next morning, his international secretary or his marketing agent from, you know, that is Miss Sylvia Abens. She is from Barcelona. She contacted me over phone, and also she put a mail. She said that she has instruction from Paulo Coelho to approach me and to give all the things. You know, in next 2 days, I got all the papers. I shared the papers. And she was telling that, no, this is amazing, sir. This story, you know, I don't believe. I said that, you know, you are too young. You are 20 years old. I am 62 years. I have sent many mails to many celebrities, And but you know, someone is replying to me. See, he has 10 million followers, and you know, he may have 10 million mails a day, but you know, he is picking up one particular mail and he's replying, and you know, he is concerned about me. You know, it shows that how nice person he is. And she has given all the credit in that. You know, as far as I told you, you know, we cannot do much in this country. You know, if you go on the street, we have a lot of program for our children. You know, our government has a lot of programs. If you say that, you know, they'll raid my house to see whether we have any children employed at our office or place, they'll put a sticker. You might have seen that. I'm asking them, suppose I'm employing a child here, you know, we cannot give back its childhood. At least I'm giving a decent life to that, picked from the street, and I'm putting that. Suppose you take this child back, what are you going to do? They said, if you find a child in your place, we'll put a penalty of 20,000 to them. That is fine. You know, I'll start getting the children and I'll call you. You take children from there and take 20,000 rupees. And in that 20,000 rupees, what is your program for that child? They said, we don't know, sir. We have only this. You know, collect this. And what you are going to do this particular child, you know, what you are taking from my building now, suppose you find that. They said, no, we'll put them to the remand home. They don't have any program. You know, they come to a house. You know, I don't say that, you know, we are not ill-treating the child. You know, not necessarily everybody has to treat well. But whatever way you will treat, no beating and all that is there. We are seeing that in such cases, yeah, they have to interfere. And in some cases, you know, once upon a time, you know, maybe a year back, I picked a child from a street and I brought it to my home. You know, she was 10-year-old. With the same Vimla auntie's help, we got an admission in a school. And, you know, she was coming from a school and a holiday. Some people have come from labor office. They said, no, I'm not supposed to keep them. You know, with the great difficulty, they took some money and took the child back. And after some time, after 3 months, I'm seeing the same child. I saw the same child in the street again. They have no program. See, here what I thought that, you know, every child, you know, my policies, every child has a talent. You know, the moment you go to a government school and speak to the children, they say that, you know, these are useless children. You know, they don't fit anywhere. You know, all the best scored children, they're going to the best schools, the convents and the best schools. But these children, the useless, there were no takers for them. So they're getting into our school, and that is the liability to us, not a non-performing asset. It's a liability to us. You know, with such children, if you talk, or my experience, I'm always telling you, Paulos, in my last 30 years, till this date, I had to find a child without a tyrant. You know, any children you take, it as a tyrant. I found a children only without a dream. You give them a dream. You know, for example.